न जाने क्यों लड़कों सी नहीं होती.
People say that women and men are just different by nature. But would it surprise you to know that people didn't always believe that the sexes were so inherently different? In fact, from ancient times to the 18th century, the Western world primarily believed there was one biological sex. People were regarded as variations of a single male sex, and females were males who did not develop fully because of a lack of vital heat. It was in the 18th century that science began to categorize two distinct sexes with inherent biological differences. Researchers in different fields built on this binary through theories that reinforced not only the difference between male and female humans, but female inferiority. For example, one theory asserted that females have smaller skulls and therefore lower intelligence than males. But it was no coincidence that white male scientists developed these theories of biological sex differences at the exact moment when these theories were socially and culturally convenient. Just as white women were demanding rights like voting and a greater role in life outside the domestic sphere, these scientific theories justified their place in the home by proving that men and women were just built differently. But not only was this rooted in a sexist ideology, but it was also strongly connected to the racist development of evolutionary sciences at the time. Many of the scientists who advocated the sexual difference model argued that the more evolved a race was, the more pronounced the sex differences were. Others argued that white women as a sex were inferior to white men, much the same way that other races were inferior to white men. Even after society turned a critical lens on the racist and sexist histories of many of these theories, the predominance of the two-sex model remained. It got even more entrenched in the early 20th century when scientists discovered sex chromosomes and concluded that the XXXY pairings of these chromosomes determined if humans were male or female. But here's the thing. Biological sex, the thing we've been taught, is an objective fact ultimately responsible for the natural differences between men and women, is less of a binary than we've been taught. Scientists estimate that as many as 1 in 100 babies are born intersex, with biological characteristics that can't be classified as either male or female. Secondary sex characteristics like breasts or facial hair, supposedly the markers of male and female bodies, are actually influenced by a host of biological factors and not just X or Y chromosomes. And recently, the debates around whether female athletes with high testosterone levels should be disqualified from competing in women's categories brought the problem with this sex binary to the forefront. It showed us that even the ways in which we calculate what levels of testosterone make you male or female are completely arbitrary. And yet, this sex binary continues to be the basis on which society heaps gender norms and expectations upon people. Anyone who doesn't follow these expectations feels the discrimination as someone who is somehow unnatural. We see this in the treatment of trans people, intersex people, and cis men and women who don't conform to these expectations. So maybe it's time we acknowledge that the sex binary is a little more nuanced than we thought, and so many of the expectations we impose are based on a framework that's not rigid. We'd be much more liberated as a society and as individuals if we critically questioned these supposedly natural frameworks and gave individuals the breathing room to exist freely outside of them. Thank you for tuning into this week's Overthinking It video. If you enjoy overthinking with us, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the Swaddle, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you stay updated.